Today, we are going to discuss the another type of mirrors called spherical mirrors. Spherical mirrors. If you see,
yes, sir,
in our previous class, we discussed that the types of mirrors will be of two types. That is, one is plane mirror and another one is spherical mirror. Okay. So, according to that, we will have a mirror which will be in the shape of a sphere. Which will be in the shape of a sphere. Suppose this is the center. Okay. Suppose let us consider the center of the spherical mirror as C. Okay. Now, if I divide this spherical mirror, into two parts, okay, such that you can see I am shading the region. This is the first part. I am shading the region. You can see that is my first part. Okay, and this one, it is the second part. Okay. All of you, can you see?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, individually observe the two parts. Now, individually, I'll observe. Okay. This is the first part. Okay. And this is my second part. Okay. No? This is the first part. And this is the second part. Okay, fine. Now, observe in the first part, that is like this. Whenever a light ray is incident, then what happens if a light ray is incident? Like this. Okay. Since the inside surface, it is coated, then I can call it as a mirror. Because what we know is,
yes,
that,
sir,
in the mirror, one of the surfaces is coated with insulator or opaque object, opaque substance. So, whenever a light ray is incident, then what will happen here, since the light ray will get diverges, okay, like this it will go. Whenever I extend it back, okay, see, it is like an V shape. Okay, now this shape can be called as, we'll call it an vex or wedge. We can call it an wedge. Okay, even in some of our homes, okay, we'll have the photo frame which will be in the shape of vex shape. Anytime, have you seen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It will be in the vex shape. Okay. So, whenever a light rays are incident on this first part, it will goes in the shape of a vex. That's why it can be called as convex mirror. Okay, na? Fine.
Okay, sir.
Next, now here it is, second part. This is the first part. Now comes to the second part. Okay, that means whenever a light ray is incident, you can see this one, suppose here. Okay, now whenever a light ray is incident, here in the first part, the light ray gets diverged. Whenever we extend it back, okay, we got it as vex shape. Okay, here we don't have any diversion. Okay, whenever a light ray is incident, suppose like this, what will happen? Okay, the light ray will get converges. Okay, the light ray will get converges. That means here.
Yes.
Like this. Okay, fine. Now, That means the light ray is going into the deeper, or it is like the light rays are going, into a cave, Like, I think in Maharashtra, there are the two places called Ajanta and Ellora.
Yes, sir.
Both are historically famous for caves.
Yes, sir.
Okay, both are historically famous for caves. Okay, fine. Now, that means cave means it is just like an hollow space where we can go inside much more deeper.
Yes, sir.
Like that, here also the light rays are going much more deeper. Okay, fine. Here we don't have any, that is, it is coated with an opaque substance. Okay. That's why it can be called as concave. Since one surface is coated with an opaque object, so we can call it a concave mirror. So initially we are having the diagrams for, or the block diagram. The block diagram for concave mirror and convex mirror. Concave mirror means like this. Here I am writing. Concave mirror. Okay. And convex mirror. Like this. Okay. Fine.
Okay, sir.
Remember these diagrams, most important. Sometimes they asked in the one mark questions, BSAQ. Draw the diagram of concave mirror and convex mirror. With the help of these, we'll have the ray diagrams. Afterwards, we'll have the ray diagrams. Okay. Same as like before, we'll have the center of the mirror, that we are calling it as pole. And focal point, center of curvature. Okay, na? Fine. Similarly, here center it is the pole. And this can be called as principal axis. Okay, na?
Yes.
Principal axis. Okay. So here we'll have the focal point, and here it is center of curvature. If you observe here, you can see the first part, from the curved surface to the right side, towards right.
Yes, sir.
Center of curvature. Okay. And for the second part, towards left side.
Yes, sir.
That's why I kept C. C means that it is center of curvature. F means what?
Focal point,
or simply you can call focus.
Okay, sir.
Call focus. Anything. Focal point or focus, both will be the same. Okay. Okay, fine. Now, next one. That is the schematic diagram, and we know the principal focus and this one. Okay, fine. And suppose, let us consider I'm having either concave mirror or convex mirror. Say, for example, suppose I'm considering the concave mirror. Okay, this is my principal axis, and here it is the focal point, and C it is the center of curvature. And suppose, let us consider I am having an object, and please remember that here object, it may be point object or it may be extended object. We can consider anything. Okay, and observe carefully here. While drawing the ray diagrams, or here enter in this chapter, I am considering as real object. Always I am considering the object as real.
Okay.
Afterwards we'll discuss about virtual object. First we'll discuss the for real object, what type of image will be formed, like real or virtual. And even in your NCERT textbook also, we are having only for real object.
Okay.
Only depends upon the interest in the subject. I am discussing about if we have virtual object, what will happen? What type of image will be formed by concave mirror and convex mirror? Like that.
Okay.
Suppose let us consider the object as AP. This is the pole of the mirror. So here we are having the sign convention or sign convention. That is, the sign convention explains about whether object distance, image distance, and focal length are positive or negative, and how we'll measure this object distance and image distance. How we'll measure the object distance and image distance, that we are going to see. Okay, here we are having three rules. First rule, all distances, that is object distance, image distance, and focal length, all distances are measured from pole only. Okay, suppose let us consider here, this is M, this is M. AB is my object and MN is the image. MN is the image. Now see here, from the pole to the object, okay, this is the object distance. Okay.
From
the pole to the image, this is image distance. Pole to the focal point, this distance, it is focal length. Okay, is it fine? That is the meaning of the first rule.
Yes.
All distances are measured from pole only.
Yes, sir.
Next, second one, the most important, please pay concentration. If the distance measured from the pole is along the direction of incident light, then the distance measured will be positive. Comma. Positive. Suppose, you see, next third one, it is, if distance measured from the pole is opposite to the opposite to the direction of incident light. Direction of incident light. The direction of incident light. Then the distance measured will be. Negative. Will be negative. Okay, na? Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now you can see here it is. I am measuring the object distance from pole to the object. This is my object distance. Whenever I place the object here, the light rays will fall. That is, it is moving towards right, like this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So towards right is my direction of incident light. Direction of incident light. Now here you can see object distance. I am measuring the object distance towards left, but direction of incident light is towards right now. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So object distance will be negative.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Object distance will be. Will be negative. Similarly, image distance
negative.
Okay, fine. Image distance from pole to the image. Again, I am measuring the distance towards left, but direction of incident light is towards right.
Negative, sir.
Negative. Similarly, yes, focal length. Similarly,
negative.
Focal length. So for concave mirror, it is U, V and F. All are negative.
Yes, sir.
Okay, na? Okay. Next, fourth point. If object or image lies above principal axis, above principal axis, then size of object or image considered as positive. Okay, na? Considered as positive. Whereas object or image lies below the principal axis. Below the principal axis. Then we can say that size of object or image will be negative. Okay. Always the size of the object will be indicated with H naught. That is height of the object or size of the object. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
So, and this one, image, will indicate with HI. The suffix O indicates that object. I indicates for image. Okay. Since object is lying above the principal axis, so H naught will be positive. Okay. Image is lying below the principal axis, so HI will be negative. Okay, na? Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
These four rules are comfortable. See, first one
yes,
is
sir.
all distances are measured from pole only. From pole only, we should measure. Next, if distance measured from the pole is along the direction of incident light, then distance measured will be positive. Okay. Otherwise, that is, if distance measured from the pole is opposite to the direction of incident light, then the distance measured will be negative.
Okay, sir.
Write down the sign convention and diagram. Draw the diagram.
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
Yes, sir.
Okay, no? Completed.
Yes, sir, one doubt. Sir. I have a doubt, sir. What does MN indicate?
What is
MN?
MN.
Sorry.
Images.
Image. Okay, sir.
Image. Okay. This one. I'll write it as object. Okay, up to here you wrote whereas.
Yes,
object or image, object or image lies below principal axis, lies below principal axis, then size of object or image can be considered as negative. Size of image can be considered as negative. Can be considered as negative.
Yes, sir. Done.
Done. Okay. Both of you done.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay. After having the sign convention, okay, here suppose let us consider concave mirror. Okay, this is my principal axis. Okay, I'll put as PA. PA stands for principal axis. Okay, such that here this is the pole. Pole means center of the mirror, can be called as pole. And here we'll have focal point, and this is my center of curvature. Okay, fine. So,
okay, sir.
Object can be placed in 6 different positions. Object can be placed in 6 positions. In 6 positions. They are number 1. Object will be placed at infinity. Object will be placed at infinity. And second one, it is between infinity and C. And C. This, in some textbooks, they will write it as beyond C. That is here. Between infinity and C. Okay. Next, third one, at C. C means what?
On C.
C means center of curvature.
Yes, sir.
I think before we discussed. C means center of curvature.
Yes, sir. Yes.
And fourth position it is, that is first initially at infinity, far distance. Slowly we are moving the object towards the mirror. Then beyond C, at C, then between C and F, between C and F. C means center of curvature, F means focal point, or simply focus, or simply focus. Next, between C and F, next one it is at F, that is at focal point. Next, finally, it is between F and P, between focal point and pole. Okay. For concave mirror, we need to draw, okay, these 6 ray diagrams. 6 ray diagrams. Okay. And you must remember it. Okay. For this, we are having the, again, the shortcut is there. For 3 ray diagrams, I can remember easy. That is rule 1. Rule 1. That is, if object is placed at infinity, object is placed at infinity, then image will be formed. Image will be formed at F, that is focal point. Okay. If object is placed at infinity, see the first one. Object is placed at infinity. Okay, then image will be formed at focal point. Okay, now second, converse of this one, that is if object is placed, if object is placed at F,
second rule, sir.
Then we'll do one thing. For formation of image, formation of image. Then it is okay. if object is placed at F, then image will be formed. Image will be formed. Where image will be formed?
Infinity.
Yeah, very good. At infinity. Okay. In the first case, it is object is placed at infinity. So image is formed at focal point. In the latter case, it is object is placed at focal point. Okay, focal point. So image will be formed at infinity. Okay, next, last rule. That is, if object is placed, at C, that is C means center of curvature, then image will also be formed, at center of curvature only, at C only. Okay, fine. Is it fine? See?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, now, 1 minute. 1 minute. You can see here, out of the six positions, I know this one. When object is placed infinity, image is at F. When object is placed at center of curvature, image is also formed at center of curvature.
Yes, sir.
Fifth one. When object is placed at F, image will be formed at infinity.
Yes, sir.
That means out of six diagrams, I remember three diagrams. You need to remember only another three.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you need to remember another three. For another three also, after drawing all the six ray diagrams, okay, I will tell the shortcut how to remember these ray diagrams of the concave mirror. Okay, this one is completed. Rules for the formation of image.
Yes, sir.
Editing as ray diagrams of concave mirror. Okay, na? Okay, fine. First one. Object is placed at infinity. Okay. We'll have a concave mirror. And this one, it is my pole. Okay. And approximately here it is focal point. And here it is the center of curvature. Okay. Object is at infinity means that, okay, it is far distance from the concave mirror. Say for example, you can see, anytime previously, whenever we don't have this lockdown, if we are seeing the far object, suppose in the sky we are having so many stars right now.
Yes, sir.
They are at far distance. What we can observe, that the size of the star, it is very small right now.
Yes, sir. But
if you see through any device like telescope or binoculars, then we can say that the size of the star is big.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Otherwise, in our real life, what we can say that if we are seeing the train at, from the large distance, train will appear as small. But whenever the train comes to near to us, it will appear as big. Right. So, like that, similarly, okay, here what we are doing that, it is that whenever the light rays are coming from infinity, the light rays will travel parallel to the principal axis.
Okay, sir.
Parallel to the principal axis. And please remember that, okay, whenever the light ray is parallel to principal axis, it will pass through the focal point. It will pass through the focal point. See, the blue color lines, it is incident light.
Okay.
And the black color is there, na? That is reflected light rays. This is the reflected light rays. Reflected light rays. Okay. Fine. Now, this is. So, here it is. Image is formed at focal point. So, it is, I can say, point size image is formed at focal point or focus. Point size image is